60 days. There were some last minute changes as it
It's impressive.
This is another area of research that we have been
sitting at the operator console. But you see that you always look at the corners and the things just.
Okay. First time this robot really works.
Yes.
You have to learn it.
Yes, yeah.
Down, make it more reliable, and then we can just switch. Because the difficult thing was just getting the mechanics up.
And then you're off.
Head off, yes.
Yeah.
The same as in the pitch configuration, it can move along a straight line. It's move describing an arc. Another interesting.
So, as you can see, it's very artistic in that in one head. So, all the joints were perpendicular to the length
of the body. All of these values are summed up as vertical forces and a center of force is being constructed.
And you see over there what it does. It basically was connected from to a base point, and it can flip over. Until recently, it's called the Eurobot. It's a bit unfortunate name. It's also a name abused by many. So what is the Eurobot? It's basically the full capability to be astronaut, to command.
Thank you.
this was built by the fight fires in oil tanks when you can't get access.
Or if you don't know that circuit because it's remote, accidents will happen.
We developed these storage tanks as well. Storage tanks in general, from the smallest surface robot to a manhole, it then sort of goes to the bottom. There's no neutral buoyancy here. Reed probes.
Mm-hmm.
There's a transmitter receiver here. We've got four of them. And put down by stopping the robot, you can put these probes down and rotate them.
And by controlling valves here appropriately, you can push this water level down or allow it to come up.
So we would use, so the buoyancy tank means that you have to adapt to this curvature from starting with this. All the legs are flexible and the individual cups are flexible.
Without a shadow of a doubt, this has been the most...
Thank you.